For the record, my name's Lyle Rowland. I represent the 155th District. And I'd like to thank the committee and the chair for hearing my bill this morning. And I'd like to just start off by saying, I think what you're about to hear today will probably make your hair fall out. But I see some of you may have already heard some of this bill. Thank you, Charlie. The bill I'm presenting today will give some security, I feel like, to the property owners throughout the state of Missouri and others on different topics. The UN Agenda 21 issue has surfaced and has caused a great deal of concern to a large number of our citizens throughout the state of Missouri. I found out this past interim that the state of Alabama had drafted a bill and had passed that bill in their legislature to protect the citizens of Alabama. And I saw that as a remedy maybe for some of the things that was coming up here in Missouri. And that is what my bill was patterned after. I'd like to just read maybe a couple of quotes here that really got me on top of this situation and wanting to do something to remedy it. Says, this is a quote from UN's Habitat One conference from 1976. It says, land cannot be treated as an ordinary asset controlled by individuals and subject to the pressures and inefficiencies of the market. Private land ownership is also a principal instrument of accumulation and concentration of wealth. Therefore, contributes to social injustice. I fear for the property rights of our individuals in the state of Missouri that do own property. Another one was by a vice chair of the Wildlands Project. He said individual rights will have to take a back seat to the collective. This isn't a partisan issue. I was on the website when I was doing some research and found a website about Democrats against Agenda 21. So I feel like that most of our people are not in favor of what they're proposing. There's a lot of cover-up, I think, as to what the real reasons are behind it. And I have, as you saw, a large number of people that are here to testify today that will probably do a better job of explaining some of this than what I have. So with that, I'll take any questions, and then we'll get into some of our testimony.
Representative Black.
To inquire.
Proceed.
Since the non-binding resolution by the United Nations was signed by President Bush the Senior, because it's non-binding, that means it's not a law. So how could our rights be jeopardized if there's no enforcement jurisdiction to enforce it as non-binding? It's by your own volunteer from those emerging nations.
What I'm thinking it is, Representative Black, is that it's a proposal out here, and that states, counties, local governments, municipalities can adopt any of those agenda items and make it a law with that as their underlying reasons.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Representative Cracky.
To inquire, Mr. Chair.
Proceed.
Good morning, Representative.
Good morning.
So this bill is basically out of fear of what might happen. Has anything happened now that we should be concerned about, or have since 1992?
I think there's been several things that have probably happened across our country that have taken away personal property rights of people in the so-called good of the whole, and I think that a lot of those things might be able to be documented. I don't have that information in front of me this morning, but from what I've heard, that there are cases like that.
Okay. I was the government affairs director for the St. Louis Association of Realtors, and we are very much for private property rights. But I don't believe that anything in Missouri has happened that we should be fearful of. This is something that you're... I really don't know where you're coming from. I guess maybe I should wait to hear from the testimony.
I think, Representative, you will hear from some of the testimony, and they may be able to give you specific cases that they have researched on.
Okay. Thank you, Representative. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Representative Knorr.
Commissioner Duquart. Refresh my memory about a thing at the lake. Some guy owned a huge plot of land, and they wanted to take it to do something with it. Condominiums or resort or something. I hope someone's familiar with that case. Well, it was an eminent domain thing, yes, but this is part of eminent domain that in his case, in Branson area, this guy owned all this land on the side of a mountain down there, and they were going to take it. I wonder how that case turned out. I think that the state or whoever lost the case and the man kept his land, but I'd like to know if anyone's familiar with that, because
I don't know exactly if we have anyone that knows. Apparently, we do. I love to have great witnesses like these. And I don't know whether this is dealing. This doesn't deal exactly with that issue. It says here, nothing in Agenda 21 is legally binding on any government until a government at any level adopts a recommendation of Agenda 21 as a law or ordinance. And that goes back to what you were saying, Representative Black. I hope there'll be someone here. Representative, there was a big issue around the lake, and I imagine Representative Miller could even tell us more about this, that the Corps was wanting to come in and tear down like 4,000 and some houses because they infringed on a property line that the Corps was trying to enforce. And I'm maybe I'd like to refer, if I could, Mr. Chairman, to Representative Miller to answer Charlie's question.
Absolutely. Proceed.
Point of information.
Proceed. Okay. What happened in Lake of the Ozarks area was that Federal Energy Regulatory Commission came in and said that the landowners around the Lake of the Ozarks, I think there was 1,500 structures.
4,000, 1,500 homes.
1,500 homes that they said, well, you're on Ameren UE land, you got to tear them down. And so, needless to say, that caused a lot of concern, and it's in the process of being fixed. It isn't fixed completely, and some things have happened or not make some people unhappy, make me unhappy. But I believe we have a witness here today that will speak to more directly to that point and how it refers to this bill.
Thank you.
Anyone else? Representative Otto.
To inquire, sir.
Proceed.
Can you tell me then how this bill would affect that situation in Representative Miller's area, or